now it's to Austria, to Innsbruck, to the mountains for the Alpen Open. Once again, the Alps have proved to be one of the best air sports venues on the planet, as over 100 pilots are in the Austrian Tyrol for the 18th annual FAI Alpen Open. I feel I'm ready to take on anything. I'm blessed with beauty. I'm streets ahead of any opportunity.
Wir sind hier in Nadenwald. This is by Hall.
We're here in Gandewald, about 15 kilometers away from Innsbruck, for the start of the 18th International Alpen Open. The motto of this year's event is to run with the eagle, to fly along the path of the eagle. So we're going to try and follow the path of the eagles through the Alps and see what happens. We've got about 100 entrants in three categories. That's paragliders, hang glider class 1, flexi clients, and then the star flyers.
There can be no better venue for an international hang gliding event, both in terms of the conditions it provides for competition and the spectacle it brings. So, day one saw the pilots set off for the first launch site on the Seegruber near Innsbruck. So, having gathered on the summit of the Seegruber with an incredible view of Innsbruck below, pilots checked their GPS coordinates for what should be a fairly easy first task. The starts en masse, but the gliders spread out very quickly, everybody looking for the chance to break away from the pack. With 4 days of flying ahead, there's no taking it easy. So with no major dramas for any of the pilots on day one, we asked Freddy Bircher of Switzerland about the navigation.
Ja, man entwickelt natürlich das Gefühl für das Gerät.
Well, naturally, one develops a feeling for the equipment itself. That's the absolute basics. You need to feel what it's doing, if it goes left, or if it goes right, or if it suddenly climbs. And of course, one has the gadgets, like this variometer. In the top display, it shows how fast one climbs or falls in meters per second. And when I lift this up, it gives an audible signal. And on the GPS, I can see in which direction I should fly. I program the route in that I want to fly and see that the first checkpoint that I have to reach is here, and the arrow points me in that direction exactly. But I still think that you do most flying simply by feeling. You feel when you fly into a thermal, and you react accordingly. You consider it slowly and then turn straight into the center and try and find where the best climb rate's going to be.
So much for the technicalities. What about the pleasure of flying a hang glider? Here's Jörg Bajewski of Germany.
It's an absolutely fantastic feeling, of course. But the problem is, it's very difficult to explain to someone who's never actually flown before. It's simply a superb feeling to fly inside a thermal and to experience what man and nature, what energy one can harness with the other. Tactics, yeah, well, of course, to finish quickly. I think, of course, that it goes without saying that we are completely at the mercy of the thermals. You have to read them. To simply miss one and go, oh, so what? And of course, the guy behind you, he flies into it, he gets the lift that he needs, and he's got the advantage. Then you yourself, you can gain the advantage.
Mm-hmm.
task is relatively long. Das heißt, man muss am
well, today's task is relatively long. That means that you have to take care at the beginning to stay with the leading pack. And then what we call a pulk is formed, like around 10 to 15 pilots that all have a similar sort of ability. And then it's a bit like bicycle racing. Tactics come into play. You don't have to give anything away. I think that this then stays so for around 3/4 of the day's route. It's like flying with friends at that point. And then finally to the sprint, the last 30 kilometers or so, no more friends at that point.
Cross-country flying, which is what we do here, is it's a very objective sport, all right? You have a set task and you have waypoints where you have to fly around. Doing a course racing, it's very, very similar to sailing. This is the closest thing that I can ever explain to someone about. Sailing, you have to go around a course and you come back to a point, or you go to somewhere else and, you know, whatever the case may be. Hang gliding, it's exactly the same. It's just that we have the third dimension that we have to deal with.
Over 4 days, the pilots covered something like 360 kilometers, and despite the bad forecast, the last flying day brought perfect conditions. A mind-blowing journey lay ahead, 95 kilometers completed in under 2 hours. So after 4 days of flying, time for the final reckoning. Third in the paragliders was Hannes Huber. Second, Richard Trumel. And the lucky winner, Gerald Amster, with 2,686 points. Third in star flyers, German Tim Gabrowski. Second, Walter Gephardt. And the lucky winner from Slovenia, Primož Grikar, with 3,031 points. In the flexible class, Michael Friesen-Biechler is third, Tom Weisenberger second, and the winner, Gerolf Heinrichs, with 3,521 points. So the 18th International Alpine Open has proved to be a great success. To travel through the Tyrol on an eagle's wing was a breathtaking experience for the international field of competitors.